And a very good Monday to everybody. Joel here with the tropical update from the J7409 Weather Channel. I hope everyone had a very good weekend. Yes, I know these things have popped up. I saw it pop up yesterday and then last night. I didn't make a video on it because I wanted to have time to go over some things to see what might happen. We got two disturbances out here, okay? Disturbance number one. Now, it's a tropical wave. It's going to move west off the west coast of Africa probably Wednesday or Thursday. It hasn't moved off yet, okay? Later this week is when it's going to move off, and there is some slow development of the system possible late this week. It's going to move west-northwestward or northwestward across the Atlantic. Now, in 2 days, it's nothing. In 7 days, it has a 30% chance of developing. And then we have disturbance number two. It's another area of low pressure, and it could develop by middle to the latter portion of this week also over the tropical Atlantic. It has some slow development also possible while it's moving just about the same direction, west-northwestward. 0 in 2 days of forming, 20% in 7 days of forming. Now, we're going to check out all kind of things. And I'm going to go over to the Eastern Pacific and the Central Pacific. And something that's really caught my attention, all the bad fires in Hawaii. Bless their hearts. Something I just don't understand. They say, now, I know I followed Dora. You heard me go on. She won't die. She's still a major hurricane. La da da. Well, a few years ago, Hurricane Michael, which was a Category 4 hurricane, was just off my coast, right about in here, just about 100 or 150 miles. We didn't have just some breezy wind. It was a large storm. We had no rain, but we did have flooding. Because it's such a huge storm, it swells the water up. The water's got to go somewhere, right? We did have some flooding. Now, what gets me is, I want to show you something. Today, as we look at Hawaii, here's the islands, here's Hawaii, and they do have Tropical Storm Greg right now over here. Now, the winds are 40 miles per hour. The pressure's 1,005 millibars. It's located 11.3 north, 139.8 west, and it's moving west just like Dora did, okay? It's moving around 13 miles per hour. Now, here we have Hawaii. Well, folks, let me tell you something. Dora was way down here, okay? These folks are saying the wind blew out of the east. Now, as it moves across, it was a big storm. It wasn't that much wind, but there could have been some wind coming from the eastern quadrant. There could have been some wind. But let me tell you what, there was no flooding, no rain. It doesn't make sense. Okay? That's all I got to say about it. I know a lot of things are sprayed in the air. One thing that is part of what goes into making gasoline is ethanol bibromide, okay? That's some of the stuff and some of the stuff that's sprayed up in the air. Now, I'm not saying that's what happened. I have no idea because it is very dry. It was very dry. But another thing you have to look at, and you know, the Chinese just not long ago, they beamed a laser beam down in Hawaii, okay? Maybe they were testing something to see when the conditions were right. They could set a fire with what chemicals were already mixed in the soil and the grass. I don't know. All I know is I had a Category 4 hurricane that was closer to me than what Dora was to Hawaii. I had some wind, not bad wind, but I had flooding. Why did they not get any flooding from this storm Dora? Lots of stuff going on in the Central Pacific. Here is Hurricane Fernando. Winds of 125 miles per hour. Barometric pressure 959 millibars, located 15.6 north, 117.7 west. It's moving west around 8 miles per hour. And then over here, we have another disturbance off the coast of South Mexico. It's a tropical wave, and it is continuing to produce a broad area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms off the southern coast of Mexico, Guatemala, and El Salvador. Now, the environmental conditions do appear conducive for development, and a tropical depression is expected to form within the next few days, and it's moving west-northwestward, roughly parallel to the coast of southern and southwestern Mexico. 2 days, 50% chance. 7 days, 90% chance. Let's check out the Saharan dry dust on the latest satellite at this moment. Okay, here we go. We got these systems that are going to be coming off over here. Remember, one of them haven't come off yet. One of those systems hasn't come off yet. But see, we got dry dust up here. It's not that much right now at the moment. It's got some sprinkles over the entire island chain over here. Nothing going on in the Gulf or the eastern seaboard, so far as a lot of dry air up to North Carolina, down to Florida. Nothing around in the Gulf areas here at this time. But let's check out some more things right quick. We'll come over to the infrared, if we can get to it right quick. You can see here's one system that's popped off. Another system's going to pop off over here. But nothing looks like it's going to happen over in these areas as of today. I think for the next maybe week, everything will be okay. But I got a feeling something's going to pop off down here before it's all over. Let's check out some more stuff. Oh, before I go any further, there is hardly any shear wind right here in this area now. I've checked it out. So wind shear is not going to be a problem to disrupt this right now. However, as it does move along, there's a big high pressure up here, and it's going to pull it this way, but we have some lows that's going to be coming off. It may get pulled up into a trough. I think one of these will develop, though, so let's go check some things out. Here's a Euro model, folks, okay? I've got this set for around 7 p.m. this evening. Can see this tropical wave. Yes, you guys will get some breezy winds. Nothing you can't handle. Probably in the 30s, maybe mid-30s, maybe a little higher once in a while. This tropical wave's going right on down, coming like this, as you can see. You might get a little rain out of this, but you shouldn't get a lot of drenching downpours. Not right now, anyway. When we move to tomorrow, you can see we have this little area right in here where the most wind is after the tropical wave kind of passes and goes through some. Now, over here, look at all the big waves, okay? We'll go up to, say, Wednesday around 8 p.m. Let's see what happens. Well, Wednesday at 8 p.m., we still got tropical waves, okay? And right in this area here, we have something that's trying to form in a low pressure system. It's not there yet, but it's trying to form. Now, that's one of these systems that's showing up at the National Hurricane Center. Over here, though, this wind has picked up as it starts to get closer to the southern Bahama areas. 41 mile per hour wind gusts. That's what's happening right there now. Still nothing out in the Gulf or down in the Caribbean, but we do have that little area that I showed you. Okay, so we're going to move on through. They said Thursday something should start to move off the coast of Africa, and here it is, as I just showed you. It was trying to do something. Couldn't even see it like late Wednesday, but by Thursday morning, something will try to start to get together here. Now, back over here, as this tropical wave comes through, it's going to be bringing at least mid 30 to 40 mile per hour winds from central to southern Bahama areas, okay? That's what you guys can expect to get. Now, we'll go to Friday midnight. You can see now, this is beginning to try to get some vorticity to it. Trying to close in, try to make something. Let's see what some of these winds are. Not too bad, 37 mile per hour winds. Now, Saturday at 9 p.m., it gets pulled up. As we turn on the pressure gradient, let's see what happens. You can see it's a low pressure system. It doesn't have but one little isobar around it. It's a low pressure, 29.83 for the top number, 29.76 for the lower number. Still hadn't done a lot over here. This is tropical wave. You're going to get beat to death, all of the Bahamas, by Saturday night. You'll have some tropical winds. I mean, nothing that you're not used to, okay? And you'll have sporadic rain off and on. Then we got a low pressure right here. Now, this is our day, the 19th. But all of that stuff's going to change, folks, okay? Now, we'll hop over to Sunday around 8 p.m. and see what happens. Now, you can see right here, this is beginning to move northward, which is a very good thing. Still, you got tropical activity, so far as tropical wave activity, all the way in the Dominican Republic, the Bahamas, portions of Cuba. Right now, it's just south of Jamaica on Sunday at 8 p.m. Over here in the Gulf, looks like something might try to form. I don't think it will right yet. We'll have to wait and see. We got to wait and see about all these things because we're going far, far out, okay? When we get to Monday around 9 p.m., you can see this is still looking like tropical moisture that's going to be brought up through this wave right in here, okay? This isn't a storm of any kind, just 35 mile per hour wind gust, okay? Now, this is Monday on the 9th, 21st. A week from today. And this system looks like it did try to do something, but it's going to get pulled up northward. It's going to get pulled up northward, as you can see right in here. It's beginning. It wanted to do something. It didn't make it that far. Then you can see it disintegrate a little more. The center of it's right over in here. You don't even see the other one, okay? And the barometric pressure is beginning to go up because high pressure is pushing it. We got high pressure over here. Kind of going to get caught right up in here. So we'll go on out to Wednesday the 23rd. You can see it does get pulled up in the trough. I was right up in here. A low trough will and pull it on out. That's what it's looking like now. Okay. Then we have another one right down here. We're going to have to keep our eyes on. No big deal right now. Just something that may materialize in days to come. Something I do want everybody to pay strict attention to. Now, right in this area here, I think this little high, which isn't very high, 29.81, I think it may have a chance to maybe try to form into something. We're going to have to wait and see. We'll go check out the GFS and see what it says. And by the way, the Euro and the GFS are not in agreement at this time, totally. We went out as far as we could on the Euro to the 23rd, so I've set the latest updated GFS to August the 23rd, as you can see. Now, what I was looking at right in this area here, right around in here, still nothing, and you can see little things are popping off, but let's see what happens as we move through time. Now we're up to the 24th, and it does look like a low is going to start to try to get together. Even though it's still 1,005, it's going to try to get together. Why? No wind shear, no dry dust, very hot water. That's why. We'll watch it and see if it does develop as we go on. We always know that the GFS tries to be a bully, wants to go faster. That's because it measures a wind at a higher distance than the Euro model does. The Euro is more down to the ground measuring than the GFS. And right here, you can see over Cuba, this low, it's just a low pressure at this time, tries to form, gets back out into the Atlantic, then kind of hovers around southern Florida. It's just a low pressure though, okay? Don't freak out, not a storm. Then it tries to move on off the coast of Florida as a low, and then it gets out in the water, and then you can see more isobars. The barometric pressure is falling. And then it comes up to the North Carolina coast. As you can see, looks like it's going to stay off the coast right now, which will be a blessing. But we need to watch over the next period of days, folks. In about a week, I think something may try to get in the Gulf or up the coastline here. So far as the other two systems go, this is what it looks like right now. Now remember, it can change. It can change. By this afternoon, it could be all different. I'm just telling you what it looks like to me right now, okay? So we'll go over to disturbance number one. I think this may have a chance of developing, as we saw, but I think it's going to get pulled up in a trough, disintegrate, and go on up and out. Now, for this one right here, we're going to have to watch. I think it's going to try to go over this way. But remember, it's going to get into some Saharan dry dust, okay? Big old glob was coming down. I'm not saying that it's going to affect it right now. It's too early to tell, my friends. So everyone just needs to make sure you're ready, because we are in the midst of hurricane season, and we have been, and it is going to ramp up as the days go by. Mostly for the Bahama areas right in here, I'll say central to southern Bahamas, I think you will get some gusty winds. I think you will get some rain out of this. And even some of the northern island areas, you may get a little bit of gusty winds. As of now, not a tropical storm, not a hurricane. I don't think this one is going to form into anything really ferocious. This one will try to get up to tropical storm, but I think it's going to run into a problem as it goes up into this dry dust and gets pulled up into a low trough and pulled on up and out. And that's what it's looking like right now. Do not fret. If I see anything at all, you know I'm going to put it up here for you. You know I'm going to keep you informed. Have yourself a good day, a safe day, and a blessed day. We do need to watch within the next, I'd say, 5 to 7 days, anything that comes up this way and starts to turn into a low pressure system. We really need to watch this area a lot, okay? Stay safe, my friends. Be blessed. Share this information with your friends, your family, and on your social media to help me keep people aware and safe of what might be coming their way. I love you all. I thank you for everything you do for me. Peace, love, and kindness to all. Thank you so much for watching.